Hello boys and girls, this is iNeo. Today I'm gonna show you how to disable any Wi-Fi enabled device without knowing any passwords. In this tutorial, we disconnect the victim from every associated client or access point and make it impossible for it to reconnect to any other while our jammer is activated. This means that the victim disconnects not only from the internet but also from any local network, rendering the target unable to perform any networking activity. This method works on routers, smartphones, laptops, printers, etc. So let's start. The first thing that you're gonna need is a working Linux distribution. In my case, I use Kali Linux, but you can use whatever you want as long as you have Aircrack installed and also MDK3. If you don't have them, you can install them by just typing this command. But I assume most of you are using Kali or Bagdrop or something similar. However, I already have them installed, so I don't need them. Anyways, you're gonna also need a working wireless card. In my case, I use TP-Link WN722N, which supports packet injection. So first of all, plug it into your computer. Okay, you wanna run the command aircrack-ng. Not airmon-ng, sorry. And this will list all the available and supported wireless interfaces. In my case, we are gonna use WLAN 2, which is the TP-Link card. And you wanna put it in monitor mode. You can do this by typing airmon-ng start WLAN and start and the interface name. In my case, it's WLAN 2. If you optionally want, if you experience any problems, you can kill this process by typing pkill and process name, for example, your manager. But it's not really necessary. So anyways, let's scan the target. You can do this by typing aerodump-ng and the monitor interface name, which is in our case it is mon0. This will list all the available routers but also clients such as mobile phones, laptops, etc. Okay, so there are two ways that you can perform this attack. The first one involves attacking an access point, which will actually disconnect all the connected devices to it and render it unusable. However, if you want, you can also attack a station, a client, such as a smartphone, and just disable the connectivity only on this device. In our case, I'm gonna attack my own home Wi-Fi network, which is this one. And you're gonna see it, how it works. Anyways, so first of all, note down your DSSID and your channel in case you want to attack an access point. Type echo the DSSID address to a file. You can name it whatever you want. I will name it victim. And then you wanna type MDK3, your monitor interface name, D for the authentication attack, B, specify the file name, and you wanna also specify the channel number, which is 1 in our case. And now you're gonna see it working. So this is my phone currently connected to our home network. As you can see, it works like a charm. And let's start the attack and see what happens. see it immediately disconnected, plus all of the other devices. So this is how it works. You can just stop the attack by pressing Ctrl C. As you can see, my phone immediately reconnected after I stopped the attack. However, for example, if you want to attack only a certain client, such as this phone, you just have to type its MAC address on the same command over here. We're gonna scan once again for networks. Now we're gonna follow exactly the same procedure, but with a different BSSID, my phone's one. The difference now is that we attacked just our phone, not affecting any other device. It won't be able to communicate with any Wi-Fi network. Note also that you don't have to specify the channel argument like I do. If you do so, it will block the communication just on channel 1. Pretty much it how it works. When I stop the attack, it will immediately disconnect back to my home Wi-Fi. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, have a nice day.